Hello and good evening and welcome to a special edition of Sports News. I'm Gautam Roy. But over the course of the last few days, we have been profiling and speaking one-on-one with India's stellar sportspersons who brought the country laurels at the international stage. And today we have the pleasure of hosting a record-breaking para-athlete, Sharad Kumar. He smashed the continental record to win gold medal in men's high jump at the Para-Asian Games 2018 in Jakarta. Sharad was 2 when he was diagnosed with polio. Sharad made his international debut in 2010 at the Asian Para Games, and in 2012 he became world number 1 by jumping 1.7 meters at the Malaysian Open Para Athletics Championship. More in this report.
Being a sportsman requires dedication, passion and an athletic body. Athletes are people who show us the peak of what a human body can achieve. But what if the athlete is paralyzed? Will he or she be able to set an example to the world? Well, Sharad Kumar, an Indian para-athlete who became differently abled at the tender age of 2, has proved everyone wrong and has become the world number 1 para-high jumper. In the recently concluded Asian Para Games in Jakarta, Sharad won gold medal in the men's high jump T42 by 63 category. Sharad was just 2 when his leg got paralyzed due to spurious polio medicine. But that did not dampen his ambition to become an athlete. And from class 7, he took up high jumping and broke school and district records competing with other differently abled athletes. Sharad made his international debut in 2010 at the Asian Para Games and in 2012 became world number 1 by jumping 1.7 meters at the Malaysian Open Para Athletics Championship. Success did not stop for him there, and in 2014 he broke the existing Asian record and won a gold medal at the Para Asian Games. In Rio Paralympics, Sharad finished 6th. Sharad is 26 years old, and looking at his records, he is not going to stop anytime soon. We wish him all the best and hope he keeps making India proud. Sports Desk, DD News.
Let's go across. Sharad Kumar, welcome to DD News. Sharad, we're honored by your presence, and first of all, congratulations for that shiny piece of metal that you have in front of you. Just tell us, do you feel still feel exhilarated? It's been a few days that you got that medal, but do you feel exhilarated, still feel exhilarated by holding it?
It has been a wonderful event, and from past few days I have been trying to sip in that yes, I have won a gold medal, and that too the second time. The first time I had won in 2014 in South Korea Asian Games, there too I had set a game record where I jumped 1.80. And the best part about the second one was that I have done my life best, and also which could be Asian record at 1.90.
Yeah, this time around we broke 2 records, the games as well as the Asian record.
It has been like the whole idea of my performance has come right from the training which I was going through in Ukraine. Where the government of India had sent me for training in under tops, and after Rio 2016, where I had not performed very well, I had like come 6th, but then from there I had a target that okay, I need to prove myself and just go further ahead. And then the training has been tough, though like Ukraine is a very cold country where it goes to minus 20, and then training there I like defied a lot of things, especially nature, my body. So it has been a nice journey, it has been a wonderful journey, and I think I'm satisfied as of now.
Mm-hmm. And to what do you owe this ability to, you know, constantly improve your performance, to keep breaking records? Is it just the training or the willpower, or of course perhaps the support that you're getting?
Well, it's all part of it, because see, without one we would be just like not being able to break any of it, because see, it is a collective measure. So I think there are a lot of things that include in it, maybe my education, also my family support, also government support, also firstly this discipline which I'm trying to follow throughout, the diet and everything which I'm looking into. So I think if even one of these issues are really not there, then I would not be able to perform at my best. So under this situation I cannot just say that only one thing has that helped me to take control over my performance right now and do so well. So under these circumstances, like all of them include to perform mm-hmm. well.
And you're 26 right now, so you've got a lot of sports ahead of you as well. What targets do you have, and do you need any further support at this stage to help you achieve those targets? Because we're already talking about Tokyo.
Oh, yes. Like, the thing is, this event which I won a gold and broke a record was very important for myself to get a security so that I can be training till Tokyo 2020. I was initially also in TOPS, and now too I further think I will be carrying on TOPS program. And the government is actually very looking forward to supporting my program because they are very much impressed with my performance.
This is the central government?
Yes, the central government under MYES, Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports. There's TOPS, which is like targeting Olympic podium scheme, where the athletes get all the possible support for performing. And like, this has been a very smooth run. And I'd like to thank the government that they have a program like this for athletes, where they are secure and financially free, that they don't need to worry about anything but just perform in those field activities.
Mm-hmm. And what about support from, say, other sports bodies and the state government that you're representing?
Oh, now with good performances comes recognition, and I think they're looking forward to felicitating me. And but the other part of this,
because I believe you had some grievances on that account from the Delhi government.
Initially, there was a thing like where I was left out for a year or so for my 2017 World Championship medal, where I was yet to receive my awards. But then I think with time they have realized that I have achieved something, and they have called me for it, and now they're planning to felicitate me on that issue too.
Mm-hmm. There is, of course, that larger question which some people have been raising, some coaches, for example, Jaspal Rana has been raising, that some of these athletes, not just para, but you know, everybody who's been competing and winning at the world stage, they're getting a little too much of recognition and reward. That is leading to a negative influence on their performance. Where do you stand on that sort of an issue?
The rewards are gifts which athletes get, but the whole idea of sports has to be realized. That why did sports come into existence? It was basically to withdraw the whole human conditions, like before the fever and all these things. So that had to be eradicated. So sports was actually to promote good health, where millions and billions of dollars are spent on diseases. That had to be removed out. So sports was made a medium where all the expenditure on health was actually reduced to minimum. And rewards, well, if athletes are getting those rewards, they are actually training well, very hard. Nobody sees how much of blood or sweat we take out or cry at night when we are far away from a country. And
yes,
training to prove that.
And there are injuries.
Yes, injuries.
There are setbacks.
A lot of things that comes into this consideration. Today, when I see back, and when I was in Ukraine, I was trained alone at home in Ukraine, I would cry. I would see things like how tough it is being. But now after winning the medal, and how the government is treating us so well, the functions, the felicitation, how we are received now, it's an amazing thing. I feel that the journey, which was hardship before, I think deserves equal reward now.
Your journey has been singularly tough. I mean, you were world number one, and then the episode with what happened, you couldn't take part in the London Olympics, you were banned. How do you look at that now, when you're once again perhaps back on top? I guess you're again world number one.
Yes, that was a phase. Actually, I needed that in my life, where I was told what reality is, what is the sole existence, how ruthless a human being can be also.
What exactly happened, in your own words? I mean, what is your perspective on it?
The thing is, I had been very naive. I was a 19-year-old boy who was training, just doing my sports as it was a fun activity for me. Not knowing what could be the condition when it comes to competing, where people all looking forward to same position. This is where I had been very negligent.
This was 2012. Yeah.
So I had been negligent there, I would not deny that. But then what I have to face and suffer because of one incident which I did not deliberately do has actually changed my life, and now it has made me careful. It makes me suspicious of things that can be happening from any angle. So it has
somebody tampered with your supplements.
Yeah, there are stories, but in my ways,
and
my
you were able to establish that somebody tampered with your supplements.
I did not have a particular name per se, but I knew the people who had done it, and somewhere down I wish.
But this is criminal. I mean, it's a criminal offense, isn't it?
I was not well educated that I could file a law or a case on something like this. Hmm. Had I known about these things, I would have firstly taken a step of filing a case. And under that, I would have surely, there would be a chance where I could have won the situation.
But I'm amazed that this entire incident has not made you bitter, vengeful. You know, it could have really sunk you, but you've not dwelt on it that much. You've surmounted that challenge.
Yes, actually, there has been a time where I want to outburst about it. But then I realize there's nobody to hear me. And under this situation, I perform, like, I go on a training and I give out all my outbursts out there. And I guess it helps me train better.
Mm-hmm.
There are few things which you cannot have control over. So these are situations, one of them in my life that has happened. But now I'm living by it. And yet, I'm trying to prove the people, to my fellow athletes who had done something wrong to me, that I will fight on. Like, I have been fighting. It's been a battle throughout, ever since I have joined Paralympic committee, like Paralympic athlete I have become. It's been a war throughout, because I always gone through situations which had made me feel that, okay, I've been neglected. But now, see, people have been supportive. You know, when I'm performing, the federation, the ministry, they recognize talent and they put us forward. And that's the best part. I know that if I'm performing, nobody can stop me. But when I would not be doing that, I will leave it out myself. But as long as I'm doing it, I'm going to fight it out.
Okay, more power to you, and nobody looking for you to hang up your boots anytime too soon. But we're taking a short break at this moment. We'll continue exploring Sharad's journey. There's a lot more that Sharad can share with us, and of course, asking about the future of Indian sports as well. He's part and parcel of it. Stay tuned to Sports News.
दीदी पांचवे महीने में भी ये फुर्ती, मेरी हिम्मत तो तीसरे महीने में
कमी हिम्मत में नहीं खून में हो सकती है आज
खून में
बच्चे और तुझ पर कहीं बुरा असर ना हो आज ही जांच करा ले
गर्भावस्था में अक्सर अनीमिया यानी खून में आयरन की कमी हो सकती है अनीमिया से बचाव के लिए हर गर्भवती महिला को गर्भ के चौथे महीने से बच्चे के छह महीने के होने तक रोज आयरन की लाल गोली पौष्टिक आहार के एक घंटे बाद लेनी चाहिए ये गोलियां सरकारी स्वास्थ्य केंद्र ANM और आशा दीदी के पास मुफ्त मिल गई
ये देखो दीदी एकदम फिट
अरे वाह
आयरन है खास करे शरीर और दिमाग का विकास आओ बनाए अनीमिया मुक्त भारत
भैया जी सारी तैयारी कर ली अपने गोपाल की शादी की लच्छू सब संभाल रहा है भैया जी जूते आ गए हैं शेरवानी फिट करा लिया है
वहाँ बात की
भैया जी ऐसी बातों में मर्दों का क्या काम
वाह जब बहू आएगी तुझे पूछेगी बुढ़वा कि परिवार नियोजन का कौन सा तरीका अपनाना है तो क्या कहेगा लच्छू संभाल रहा है सिर्फ शादी नहीं शादी के बाद की समझदारी की तैयारी करो
सेहत और सोच दोनों से तैयार होकर परिवार बढ़ा रहा है फोन करें और परिवार नियोजन से जुड़ी सब जानकारी पाएं जोड़ी जिम्मेदार जो प्लान करे परिवार
भारत सरकार का अल्पसंख्यक कार्य मंत्रालय सीखो और कमाओ और गरीब नवाज कौशल विकास योजना के तहत एक सैनिटरी सुपरवाइजर्स की टीम तैयार कर रहा है जिसमें लाखों युवा साफ सफाई के आधुनिक तरीके सीखकर काम भी पा रहे हैं हमारे प्रिय प्रधानमंत्री का मिशन स्वच्छ भारत स्वस्थ भारत
कैसी हो बहन
अच्छी हूँ
आई आई पर जूते चप्पल यही उतार दी नमस्ते डॉक्टरनी जी
नमस्ते
आले क्या कर रही है बेबी
इसकी नाल तो बिल्कुल सूखी है कुछ तेल वेल लगाओ नहलाया कि नहीं बच्ची को
देखिए बच्चे को 24 घंटे तक नहीं नहलाना चाहिए इससे उसे ठंड लग सकती है और नाल पर तेल घी हल्दी वगैरह कुछ भी नहीं लगाना चाहिए इन्फेक्शन हो सकता है बस नाल को साफ और सूखा रखिए वो सूख कर अपने आप ही गिर जाएगी
शिशु स्वस्थ सालों साल जब हो सही देखभाल
दीदी पांचवे महीने में भी ये फुर्ती मेरी हिम्मत तो तीसरे महीने में
कमी हिम्मत में नहीं खून में हो सकती है
आज
खून में बच्चे और तुझ पर कहीं बुरा असर ना हो आज ही जांच करा ले
गर्भावस्था में अक्सर अनीमिया यानी खून में आयरन की कमी हो सकती है अनीमिया से बचाव के लिए हर गर्भवती महिला को गर्भ के चौथे महीने से बच्चे के छह महीने के होने तक रोज आयरन की लाल गोली पौष्टिक आहार के एक घंटे बाद लेनी चाहिए ये गोलियाँ सरकारी स्वास्थ्य केंद्र ANM और आशा दीदी के पास मुफ्त मिलती है।
ये देखो दीदी एकदम फिट।
अरे वाह,
आयरन है खास, करे शरीर और दिमाग का विकास, आओ बनाए अनीमिया मुक्त भारत।
Welcome back to Sports News, and we're talking to Sharad Kumar. He's a gold medalist at the Para Asian Games 2018 that concluded in Jakarta and broke two records there, the continental as well as the games record. Sharad, let's go back to the beginning. You contracted polio when you were two, and that has affected your left leg. It's paralyzed. Just tell us, how did you think about, taking up sports and that too high jump?
Well, luckily my father had sent me to Darjeeling in St. Paul's School, where the school actually gives equal importance to sports and education. So if we are doing any one of these, it's compulsory that you have to take part in the other two, or else you are sent to go back home. And under these conditions, I also had to take part in all the activities, be it cricket, be it like table tennis, football, and I actually enjoyed it. The best part of that was that...
How old were you then?
I was like 8 years old further. And then the best part was like no friends of mine actually made me realize that I'm different. They all selected me and actually motivated me, also promoted me to better performance. So whenever...
Wonderful, very fortunate of you.
I was indeed lucky there that I got an institute like this and also friends like that in my boarding school. So from there onwards, sports just slowly came into me. Like it was like I enjoyed more of sports than education. And I started showing interest into cricket. I became a cricket captain for my wing, representing my school to another school. Then slowly I became a good table tennis player. And then my brother, actually he was a high jumper himself too. He had many records, but unfortunately I broke all of them because I see few things. Like my brother was actually a star. He was quite popular amongst my school people in different schools. He was a total true sportsman. He was good at every sports equally. So looking at him, he used to go back home with so many medals and certificate. I had nothing. So that one way actually motivated me. Okay, I need to make my father proud and make him realize that I also have something which needs to be recognized or maybe rewarded or make him happy. So I think that was one of the most important ways to do sports. Mm-hmm. But then coming to Paralympics per se, there was this teacher, Mr. Dennis. He actually told me about Sharad that you need to go to Paralympics. These are sports for people who are physically challenged.
Okay.
So I told him, so for that I need to leave Darjeeling and go to Delhi where they'll be recognizing. He said, yes, if you have to change institute, but for the progress of your future, you should always take that step. And then I came down to Delhi. I studied in Modern School, Barakamba Road in 11-12. There they promoted sports too well. So there also I was allowed to take part in all my activities, whether it was inter-school competitions. They gave me the privilege of going for competitions which was for districts and further for state. And then slowly my teacher, there was Meera Joshi ma'am, she got in touch with the Federation of Paralympic Committee of India. Mm-hmm. And then she told me the address and everything. Then I went there. So basically it was all my teachers and guidance that they have actually got me this, what I deserve.
Wonderful ecosystem to have. I'm sure you're very thankful to them. To talk about the current scenario, do you have a similar ecosystem around you even now that is helping you perform the way that you are?
Yes, I have family who are not asking me to get married sooner. They're telling me that carry on with the sports as long as you can, because this is one thing which you like. And then another thing is like I'm getting the support, financial support from the government. That has actually taken away all my burden. And I am now in a stream where I'm enjoying what I'm doing. I have a lot of friends who are in different professions. They're making a lot of money. But then they're not there because they love that.
Mm-hmm.
It is just out of
I just wanted to ask you, what do you have against marriage?
Well, it would take a lot of my time, but I think right now I'm young and I have time. I have an elder brother, younger sister. I think they can go ahead further and then I'd get into the line.
Okay, so you're younger as well, so it's only you know, the right thing to do to wait first for the elders to get married. We'll take a short break. We'll talk to Sharad about the future of Indian sports as well, which is looking brighter and brighter in every field each passing day. Taking a very short break. Stay tuned to Sports News.
भारत सरकार का अल्पसंख्यक कार्य मंत्रालय सीखो और कमाओ और गरीब नवाज कौशल विकास योजना के तहत एक सैनिटरी सुपरवाइजर्स की टीम तैयार कर रहा है, जिसमें लाखों युवा साफ सफाई के आधुनिक तरीके सीखकर काम भी पा रहे हैं। हमारे प्रिय प्रधानमंत्री का मिशन स्वच्छ भारत स्वस्थ भारत।
कैसी हो बहन?
अच्छी हूँ।
आई आई पर जूते चप्पल यही उतारी। नमस्ते डॉक्टरनी जी।
नमस्ते। अले क्या कर रही है बेबी?
इसकी नाल तो बिल्कुल सूखी है, कुछ तेल वेल लगाओ, नहलाया कि नहीं बच्चे को?
देखिए, बच्चे को 24 घंटे तक नहीं नहलाना चाहिए, इससे उसे ठंड लग सकती है। और नाल पर तेल घी हल्दी वगैरह कुछ भी नहीं लगाना चाहिए, इन्फेक्शन हो सकता है। बस नाल को साफ और सूखा रखिए, वो सूख कर अपने आप ही गिर जाएगी।
शिशु स्वस्थ सालों साल, जब हो सही देखभाल।
चाचा, एक कुर्ता पैजामा सिलाना है।
तुम्हारा नाप तो है ही,
अपने अभी तक इन्हें अपनी छोटी सी दुकान में ही बिठा के रखा हुआ है। अल्पसंख्यक मंत्रालय की एक स्कीम है, जिसमें आपके हुनर को अच्छे तरीके से तराश कर आपको इस काबिल बनाया जाता है कि आप इस तरक्की की दौड़ का हिस्सा बने, और जरूरत के मुताबिक आपको भरपूर आर्थिक मदद भी मिलती है।
ये सब मुमकिन हुआ है भारत सरकार के अल्पसंख्यक मंत्रालय की गरीब नवाज कौशल विकास और सीखो कमाओ जैसी तरक्की की हम सफर योजनाओं से। आप भी हिस्सा बनिए। एम्पावरमेंट विदाउट अपीसमेंट।
आधुनिक और आसान होते जा रहे हैं परिवार नियोजन के साधन, जैसे नया MPA इंजेक्शन। फोन करें और पाएं परिवार नियोजन से जुड़ी हर जानकारी। जोड़ी जिम्मेदार, जो प्लान करे परिवार।
कैसी हो बहन?
अच्छी हूँ।
आई आई पर जूते चप्पल यही उतारी। नमस्ते डॉक्टरनी जी।
नमस्ते। अले क्या कर रही है बेबी?
इसकी नाल तो बिल्कुल सूखी है, कुछ तेल वेल लगाओ, नहलाया कि नहीं बच्चे को?
देखिए, बच्चे को 24 घंटे तक नहीं नहलाना चाहिए, इससे उसे ठंड लग सकती है। और नाल पर तेल घी हल्दी वगैरह कुछ भी नहीं लगाना चाहिए, इन्फेक्शन हो सकता है। बस नाल को साफ और सूखा रखिए, वो सूख कर अपने आप ही गिर जाएगी।
शिशु स्वस्थ सालों साल, जब हो सही देखभाल।
वेलकम बैक, यो इट्स स्पोर्ट्स न्यूज़ एंड वी टॉकिंग टू शरद कुमार। He's a champion Paralympian, just won the gold, in fact won it a second time successively at the Para Asian Games in Jakarta. Sharad, let's talk about the future. We've seen in the Para Asian Games itself how India more than doubled its tally. How big that is an indicator that things are changing as far as Indian sports is concerned?
I have been attached to Paralympics from 2008. And I've seen that this movement has actually gained momentum. Now athletes, they're all coming. Now they want to prove their existence. They want to prove that they are also differently. They are different. They want to prove that I am here to win. I'm here to take over also, be the popularity. Because para sports now is getting the attention what it was not getting initially. Now with all the supports coming, even celebrities coming up, supporting the movement, good guidance to the athletes, education provided to the athletes, these things are providing us with better performances. And also now, just see, for example, we just reached here one day before and the government of India just felicitated us with so much of cash award. So these way you see things, this will only encourage more people to come. And we have just won 78 medals. I would be very happy when our country would be at the table with China, where they are winning 250 medals. And that is my real aim, where I see that our country athletes are getting 280 medals. And that is possible. We have the talent. We are just looking forward to encouraging athletes that they come up and take up this responsibility or maybe the training schedule.
And will you consider being part of that jury even after you hang up your boots some years down the line? Because I know that you're academically inclined as well. You've done your master's in political science and international relations.
That is the whole purpose of me doing sports. I want to be attached to sports further. I want to set up a institute or maybe a academy where I can help athletes come, where I can educate them about sports, the real value of sports, also how to follow it in a technical way, manner. And I think I'm never going to, people say, oh, sports is a short living, you'll retire after 32. I want to tell them, sports can never end. I can be your coach. I can further go and make more athletes who will win the medals for me. So it is never going to end there. And also, we are looking at a good progress now. And it will be happening.
There have been initiatives in the recent past as well, especially by the center, things like Khelo India, apart from, you know, TOPS and everything else.
Yes, Khelo India should be one program that should be initiated even for the Paralympic athletes.
Okay.
It is for the general athletes. It's a very bright idea. This needs to be even brought to the Paralympics. And the day it's done, I'm sure to achieve that 250 tally medals, we are there. It will happen.
Well, I'm sure, you know, ears that matter will be listening to you because you're performing at the world stage, and we hope that you will bring more laurels to the country in the future. Thanks a lot for joining us today on DD News, and all the best for the future, Shabbat.